All right, what's up, guys? Welcome to today's video. I'm here with my girlfriend Lexi, and we're gonna do a video today on how girls should train. So I'm gonna be putting Lexi through a full upper body workout. When I say upper body, I mean chest, shoulders, triceps, back, biceps, and then I think that's it for upper body. So do the girls I know. Lexi actually trains, I would say, the right way. We're gonna show you guys the right way to train for girls. We're not gonna do that nonsense, hit, booty, just random crap that you see on social media all the time. It's gonna be similar to just how guys should train. That's how it should be for girls. There's nothing special about girls, nothing special about guys. We also train hard, push ourselves. So that's what I'm gonna show Lexi here and put her through today. I'm not gonna kill her any more than I would do myself necessarily, but I'm just gonna make sure and coach her through to make sure she's doing it the optimal way. And you guys can see for yourself that girls can train like this too. And I think Lexi, she's kind of bound to train pretty well just because she hangs around me so much. Just because I'm very intense with my training and stuff like that too. So I'm gonna show you, it's not gonna make you big and bulky like a guy. I mean, look at Lexi. I don't think she's overly bulky. I think she looks very good for a girl. She thinks she looks very good for a girl, and she's got a very good physique for the most part. So you're not gonna get big and bulky just like that. If anything, you're just gonna look better. But yeah, so this is gonna be for your muscles, for everything. It's gonna be really, really good. So stay tuned. We'll get you guys to it. Which is a slight incline, chest fly. And just like what I would do for myself or any other guy who's training, we did a few warm-up sets, pretty standard there. And the rep scheme we're gonna be working with today, we're already at our working weight right now. So we're gonna do just two sets here. We're gonna do one set, not to failure, which you're gonna see right now, and then one set to failure. Only two sets, but we're gonna be training pretty hard here, so she's gonna feel like she's got a good pump in her chest, there's blood flow to it, and we're just getting everything kinda warmed up here. Just because we're warming up, we're not taking it light, we're actually working really hard here. So I'm gonna show you guys that she's a girl, she's still gonna train just as hard. Let's grab your weight, let's get going. So just like everything, she's gonna get her form locked in, get those shoulders locked back as far as they need to be. Yep. Coming down nice and slow. That's good, and come up. And squeeze. We're doing about 10 to 12 reps here. There you go. There you go, squeeze your chest to get a good contraction. She's training really hard here. This is actually really hard for her, which is good. There you go, only comes on right there. You got it. Big breath of air. Do two more. One more. You got it. Okay, so now. So, that was a set not to failure. I don't know if you can see her face or not, but that was actually really hard. Did you see that was pretty hard?
Yes,
but she could have got probably another two or three more. So that means we're not to failure. So I would say that's about RPE 7 to 8. So this next set, will be to failure, or form failure, I should say. Just like the guys, we go until we can't complete a rep with perfect form. We don't want to do every single set to failure because that'll just be overtraining, but it's crucial that we hit failure. Even as guys and girls, even as naturals, even if we're enhanced, doesn't matter who you are, you have to train hard. Alright, so we're on a second set here. We rested about a minute and a half. We're gonna go to complete failure here, or form failure. So let's just start off like. Good controlled reps here. We want quantity over quantity. Good. Squeeze your chest. As you're coming up, your chest is contracting the entire time. She's only coming down as far as she is. If she goes any further, her shoulders are gonna internally rotate, and that's gonna potentially injure your shoulders. If she comes out a little bit farther, here we go, you got a few more. Down my hands. Good. Squeeze. To the top, squeeze as hard as you can. You got it. We're gonna do two more. Good squeezes at the top. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Last one. Squeeze as hard as you can. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. When she gets to the top, hold that squeeze. Good. So, That was failure. Whenever it gets really hard, she starts laughing, if that's why you're wondering why she's laughing. But if you're asking me, I would say that was forearm failure, which is really good, nice and hard, so good job. All right, guys, so we're on the first compound movement of the day, her second movement, which is gonna be a slight incline barbell bench press. So like always, I'm a big fan of starting out the workouts with an isolation movement of some kind. So we did the chest fly and slight incline, just like slight incline here. So now our tendons, everything, they're kind of warmed up a little bit better. And we're not going right into a big heavy compound. So we're gonna do here, we already went through her warm-up sets, she's already ready to go. So we're gonna start off her first set here. And the rep scheme we're gonna be doing is an 8-8-8 scheme. And typically when I do that, that means increase the weight each set until you hit a top set of failure. So this is set number one of three, not to failure. She should have a few reps in the tank after this set. But yeah, so slight incline, watch her form. She's really good at this. And I'll coach you through it. Got it. She's only coming down part way to right there. So any more, we're gonna internally rotate our shoulders, which we don't want. So, in that case, that was actually really hard for her. So, we're actually gonna keep this weight here, and instead of doing an 8-8-8, we might actually just do another set of eight, and then keep it at this weight, because there's no point, if it's already hard enough, we don't wanna go any harder just because it was written out that way. I don't care about how much weight she's doing, so like, I don't care about how much weight I do. I care about how effectively you can lift a certain weight and how hard you lift that certain weight. Where she was doing that with good form, pushing yourself very hard, and that's what matters. So I'm gonna do, we're gonna rest a little bit, and then we're gonna get back into another set. I think I'll show you guys the set to failure. So one thing I wanna talk about real quick is why girls should train chest, because Lexi's training chest and she's starting out with it. And I think it's important for girls to train chest because number one, if you wanna look good, which is why most girls train, is to look good. Having a fuller chest is gonna make you look more aesthetic. You're not just gonna have this area that girls have, but if it's fuller up here, it ultimately appears just more aesthetic looking, and it doesn't look flat. Because say if you have developed shoulders and everything, and you're a little bit slightly broader, having that fuller chest kind of goes with that, because it looks weird when you have developed shoulders but your chest is just flat up on the top here. So that's why we're doing chest training, because it looks good. Also, it's really helpful to be strong there, because just for pressing everything we're doing with our bodies, it's really functional to have a strong chest as well. So I'm really not a fan of it when girls neglect to train chest. Okay, so we did her second set. We've done the first and second set so far. So what we're gonna do now is the top final set, and this is gonna be a high intensity set. So high intensity set is when you go to failure and beyond. So she's gonna do as many reps here as she can to failure. She's most likely only gonna get like 4 to 5 reps maybe. But once you hit that to go beyond failure, I'm gonna assist her, and she's gonna do negative reps, or assisted reps you can call them. And on a barbell bench press, I normally wouldn't recommend this, but she has me as a training partner, so I'm there to spot the bar. If you're by yourself, don't do this on a barbell, save it for a machine. But if you're with a training partner, this is a great option to go nice and hard. So she's gonna go to failure and pass it. You don't see very many girls train like that, but they should train like that, so watch this. Her muscles were shaking, they were working. That's what you want, that's what training hard looks like. Her form was still good, she didn't injure herself because she kept the weight very controlled. Do you see how slow she was lowering that weight? Once you control the weight and you don't let it control you, you're not gonna get injured. So just because you do that though, you still have to train hard, which is what we did.
All right, so the next lift we had is a single arm dumbbell row, and she already did her warm-up here, so she's ready to go for this. Just like every lift, we'll do a few warm-up sets before every single movement. So we're gonna do two sets here, only two sets. First one's gonna be, it's hard obviously, but it's not gonna be to failure. So we're gonna do first set of anywhere from like 8 to 10 reps, not to failure. Rest a little bit, do a failure set. We're gonna do a failure set then, and it'll also be a high intensity set. So two back-to-back high intensity sets, two failure. So that's the plan for this. So I'm gonna have you do your first set here.
You went from 8 to 10, even 12, we'll
do it. So one thing you'll notice is I don't get too carried away with counting specific reps. I'm more so just try and hit a range of reps. And as long as you're training hard enough, pushing yourself the right way, that's all we can really ask for. Just coming up, getting a full squeeze in her lat.
There you go, come on. Get three more. Two more. One more. Control, come on, control. There you go, sit down.
So, I wouldn't call that 100% failure, but she was pushing herself really hard there, looked really good. So we're gonna do the other side now.
You said it was pretty hard?
Yes, should be very hard. Should be hard all the time, actually.
Better diet, so I'm now filming on my phone. We're gonna do a set to failure here. So whenever you're ready, you can get going. So this set's gonna be a set to failure. And at the end, once you hit failure, I'm gonna have you do a rep where you just hold it as long as you can. So the last set was hard, now this set's gonna be even harder. There you go. Good. Look at how she stretches her back at the bottom. As she comes up to the top, she gets that full squeeze. And she also drops the weight very slowly, which is good. Good control. As you can see, she's working really hard. She's not like one of those girls that goes in there and grabs a light weight, moves it really slow, but doesn't even break a sweat. She's training harder than most guys I know right now, which is good. One more, but hold it. Hold. Hold. As long as you can. As long as you can.
Warmed up Lexi's lats, we're gonna do the single arm row. So now what we're gonna do is a barbell row for a compa movement. The only downside about where we're working at right now is we don't have any cables and we don't really have a spot for her to do pull-ups because I don't think she wants to hang from the roof like I did. So we're gonna have her just do rows for today, which it's not optimal, but we'll get after it. So we already got her warmed up on the barbell row. So what we're gonna do is do an 8-8-8 rep scheme. You're gonna do a set of 8, increase the weight, another set of 8, increase the weight, another set of 8, increase the weight, but the last set we're gonna go all out to failure. So this set you're gonna see here is not to failure. So whenever you're ready.
8?
Yep. She says he's really controlled. I'll have you pause for like another second at the top. Good. There you go. She does a good job of keeping her back in line. She kept the weight the same for her, just being that we have a barbell, it's kind of hard to do really small weight increments, so we just kept it the same. But instead of increasing the weight, we increased the RPE. So the first set, she saved 2 reps. Second set, she saved 1 rep. Now we're gonna save none. We're gonna go all out to failure. Nothing special here. We're just going until we can't go anymore with good form. There you go. Let's try and get at least 8 or more. There you go. You got it. It's gonna hurt, but you gotta push through it. Come on, you got more. All right, that's it. So, that was failure, because form failure, I said. Failure doesn't mean you're all of a sudden you're just dead all of a sudden. No, it means when your form gives out. So as you see there, she couldn't complete another rep without raising her back way up straight. So that was good, that's what we wanted, so that's good work. We're on a shoulder work for the day. We already did chest work, we did lat work, so now we're gonna do our delts. We're just doing our side delts and rear delts because we already got lots of our front delts from our chest work, so there's no point in targeting them directly. So what we're gonna do here is our first superset. We're gonna superset a lateral raise with a rear delt fly with the dumbbells. I'm not a huge fan of rear delt flies, like I mentioned, but we'll still do them anyways, just because it's really all we got right now. So we're gonna start with 10 reps here. This is our first set, so not to failure. 10 to 12 reps here, then you're gonna bend over slightly, and then you're gonna do the rear delt fly. So let's get it. There you go, lead with your elbows a little bit more. There you go. Pause for a little bit more at the top. There you go. Get one more. Good. Rear delt fly. So with these, I actually like to slightly internally rotate the shoulders, just slightly, so you can target that rear delt behind, just this small muscle right here. There you go. And the hard thing about these, you don't get much tension at the bottom of the lift. So when you can do a little pause at the top, like you're gonna do right here, there you go. That really emphasizes the tension of the muscle. And these ones, honestly, if you do them right, you shouldn't need much weight at all. Like, she's using 10s and 5s here, so not a whole lot of weight. But the way she's doing them, they're still targeting her muscles perfectly. Hard?
Yeah.
Do our high intensity sets. We did our first set, rested a few minutes. So we're gonna do a double drop set here. And when I say double drop set, a drop for each lift here, because we're doing a lateral raise and a rear delt fly. So we're gonna failure, a lateral raise, drop the weight as many as you can there. Then once you finish that, go straight into the rear delt fly. To failure, once you finish there, drop the weight, go as many more as you can. So it'll take a little while, but it's gonna be past failure, really good high intensity set. So I'm gonna tell her when she hits failure, so I'll be seeing her form here. There you go, try and lead with the elbows a little bit more. There you go. She's hitting that side part of her delt. And for girls, building up that side part of your delt, it really helps you get that, like, I don't know what you call it, like an hourglass shape or something. But it helps you get that kind of tapered look and then the skinny waist. So having developed shoulders really helps. Drop the weight. So right there, she couldn't really complete another rep with good form. So I'm having to drop the weight. Bring those elbows up a little bit more. There you go. Slow it down. Pause at the top. You got two more. Drop the wrists. Bring the elbows up. Okay, this one, you're going to do one more, but you're going to hold it, okay? Hold as long as you can. Keep holding, keep holding, keep holding. All right, rear delt fly. Bend over. You can use those weights. It's going to be a long set. You got it. Internally rotate those shoulders slightly. Bring it forward slightly. Nope, your shoulders. There you go. You feel right back in here. Just bring the elbows up. Come on. There you go. Two more. Hold the last one. Hold this one as hard as you can for as long as you can. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Keep holding, keep holding. All right, drop set. Drop set in both of these guys. A really high intensity. Good. There you go. So come to the top and do slow pulses. Pulse. Come up to the top, go up and down very slightly. Just bump, bump, bump. So up and down, just like that. There you go. That's failure. Last round of workouts for the day. So right now we're gonna do our biceps and triceps. We're just doing a superset. So a straight bar curl, pretty standard. We're only doing two rounds of all this. We're doing 10 to 12 reps here. First round's not gonna be a failure. And she's gonna go directly into tricep kickback when she's done. All right, so tricep kickback. That was hard, wasn't a failure though.
Five.
Yep. So try and get 90 degrees with your back. There you go. And the only thing that's moving is her elbows, her arms, everything else is staying in place. Really good. And as you can see in here, I don't know if you can see it in the camera, but her tricep is contracting. I can see it, it's really good. Try and keep those elbows up a little bit more. Yep. Now pause for a second at the top so you can really feel those triceps because there's no tension at the bottom with these. There you go. Do like 10 to 12 here. And we're not gonna rest in between sets. The thing with biceps and triceps, typically what I find works best is if you just do a lower rest time, and instead of focusing on lifting super heavy weight, your main focus should just be trying to pump as much blood into the muscle as you can, which is gonna help it grow. So to do that, we're just gonna low rest time. So go right back into curls here, and then we're gonna try and hit failure here. If we don't get exactly failure, that's okay, but we're gonna try. So do a really slow reps here, nice contractions. Squeeze as hard as you can. I'm only gonna have you come up about 2/3 of the way, so right here. And that way we're gonna keep tension on our biceps and fill it with blood. There you go. Look how she controls it. She's not swinging her body like crazy, so that's really good. You got it. Let's hold this one for 3 seconds. Good. You got a few more. I'm gonna help you hit failure here. So we're gonna do one, I'm gonna resist. There you go. Let it down. I'm gonna resist a little bit. So this last one, hold the contraction at 90 degrees as long as you can. Hold it there, as long as you can. And you can see her breath is shaking right now. She's working really hard. There you go, that was failure. Kickbacks. There you go. Really good. Let's get a 3 second hold for each rep. Hold as long as you can. Ah, all done. Good workout.
Yeah.
So, are you tired?
Yes.
You don't feel like you hurt, like you injured nothing?
Mm-mm.
You don't feel like a big bulky gorilla?
No.
Awesome. So guys, that's how girls should train. They should train just like guys, to be honest with you. And that training session, she trained harder than most guys I know, which was really cool. And it's not like you have to lift hard weight to train. That weight you were lifting by all means was nowhere like heavy at all. It wasn't crazy weight. But the way we lifted it, you still push yourself to failure. So that means you're training hard, intensely, and your form is really good. And you can still train to failure. You're not gonna injure yourself or lose your gains when you train to failure. As long as you keep that form, tempo, everything controlled and be safe with it, which is what we were. So overall, really good training session. Girls, you should train just as hard as that. You shouldn't do any of that wimpy CrossFit, weird HIIT cardio, booty, glute band, I don't know what you wanna call it, but just that weird girl stuff that you see on social media. Train hard. If you wanna learn something, train from the hardest worker in your room, whether that's a guy or a girl. Look at that hard worker, figure out what they're doing. Make sure they know what they're talking about first off, but then just train hard, because you can. You're not gonna get big and bulky like a gorilla.